إن شاء الله we'll continue with تفسير جزء عامة based on the تفسير of سيدنا ابن كثير. إن شاء الله we are in سبح اسم ربك الأعلى. That is chapter 87 إن شاء الله. ما الذي أولياء الله؟ أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى. سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى. ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى. سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا. قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى. بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى. إن هذا في الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى. صدق الله العظيم وبلغنا رسوله النبي الكريم، ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين الشاكرين بقلب سليم. This is one of the surahs that is recited often. Prophet is known that he would recite it for Eid prayer with Surat Al-Ghashiyah, and he would recite it for Jumu'ah prayer, and he even advised Sayyidina Mu'adh when he was reciting long surahs in the Isha prayer that to make it easy, and he mentioned to him many surahs. One of them is سبح اسم ربك الأعلى, that use this one instead of along Surah Al-Baqarah or Surah Ali Imran. So this is a surah that many of you are familiar with. And it starts with glorify the name of your Lord. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى. And in two Sahih Hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, we mentioned that he mentioned to Sayyidina Mu'adh that this is one of the surah, but in a hadith that Prophet ﷺ Allahumma salli ala sallam, Imam Ahmad, he narrated or recorded that Abu An-Nu'man bin Bashir, that he said that the Prophet ﷺ, whenever he would recite سبح اسم ربك الأعلى, glorify the name, praise the name of your Lord Most High, he would say سبحان ربي الأعلى. He would say سبحان ربي الأعلى. So when you're reciting the surah اسم ربك الأعلى, Allah is basically ordering that praise your Lord Most High. And so Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم would oblige and say سبحان, after reciting that verse would say سبحان ربي الأعلى. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه. فسوى, the one who created and created in specific proportions. تقدير. فسوى means he created and fashioned it in every way. والذي قدر فهدى, and the one who estimated and measured and planned, fahada, and then guided all creation according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's taqdeer. They were Rabbana alladhi a'ta kulla shay'in khalaqahu thumma hada. This is when Sayyidina Musa was answering Fir'aun when he asked him, What is your Lord? He said, رَبُّنَا الَّذِي أَعْطَى كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقَهُ ثُمَّ هَدَى. Allah is the one who gave to each thing its form, its nature, its creation, and then guided it. So everything in this creation has been fashioned and guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he quotes the hadith that عن سيدنا عبد الله بن عمر, that the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إن الله قدر مقادير الخلائق قبل أن يخلق السماوات والأرض بخمسين ألف سنة وكان عرشه على الماء. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, verily Allah has ordained the measure of everything, all creation, the estimation of everything 50,000 years before he created the heavens and earth. And then at that time his throne was over the water. And then one would ask, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordained everything 50,000 years before he created creation, before he created heavens and earth, his throne was upon the water. And the water is a thing. Water is created. So, وَكَانَ عَرْشُهُ عَلَى الْمَاءِ. And there's a tafsir for Shaykh Abdullah Sirajuddin, one of the awliya from Aleppo, that here the water is not this water. It is the water of life, the water of reality, he said. And that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his light is the that water is the from which Allah created all things. والذي أخرج المرعى, and the one who brought forth vegetation and pasturage, فجعله غثاء أحوى, and then the greenery that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings forth and then it withers and dies. غثاء أحوى. سنقرئك فتنسى. We shall make you read, O Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and you will not forget. You shall not forget. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we, for ta'zim, we shall make you recite and we shall make you not forget. إلا ما شاء الله, except that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to forget. Sayyidina Qatada said that the Prophet did not forget anything except what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willed him to forget. فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله. إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that which is apparent and that which is hidden, seen and unseen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows everything. Nothing is hidden from Him. وَنُيَسِّرُكَ لِلْيُسْرَى, and we shall make it easy for you. We shall make that which is easy for you, we shall make it easy for you to find, to do. We will make, yani the meaning is, we will make it easy for you to do good deeds and to give good statements. We shall make it easy for you, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. And we, يعني when يسرك لليسرى, we will legislate the law for you that is easy, tolerant, straight, and just. Not difficult. We don't want to make things difficult for you, we want to make it easy. فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى. Therefore remind, in case people will profit from you reminding them. Meaning, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. Reminding is beneficial. We mentioned in Surah Abasa, وَمَا عَلَيْكَ أَلَّا يَزَّكَّ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to when the chiefs came and Prophet was trying hard to convince them. And Allah is saying, it's not your duty to convince them. Your duty is to give guidance to those who are open for guidance. فذكر إن نفعت. And this is also for people nowadays, is Prophet ﷺ said to speak to people according to their abilities of comprehension and understanding. Mawlana Sheikh Nazim used to say, you don't throw gems to children. Children are interested in candy, a ruby or an emerald, and you give them chocolate. They're going to choose chocolate. They don't appreciate, they don't understand the value of gems. So here the author is quoting that Sayyidina Ali said that don't tell people any statement or any information that their intellect or their cannot grasp, cannot understand, because it will be a fitna for them, a trial. It may cause them to disbelieve. Allah knows. And he also said, tell people that which they know. And speak to them according to what they know, in words they understand. Because he said, would you like for Allah and his messenger to be rejected? Otherwise, if you speak in a difficult way to people, they may reject each, and by doing so, reject Allah and his prophet. سَيَذَّكَّرُوا مَنْ يَخْشَى. The ones who will heed your reminders will are those who have already belief and fear for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The people that will receive and accept your guidance are people with already who already have some khashya, fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَتَجَنَّبُهَا الْأَشْقَى الَّذِي يَصْلَى النَّارَ الْكُبْرَى ثُمَّ لَا يَمُوتُ فِيهَا وَلَا يَحْيَى. The ones that will reject you, will avoid you, are the wretched ones, the unbelieving ones who are destined for hellfire, in which they will neither die nor live. Means in hellfire, people will experience torments, but they will never expire, they will never die. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. They will keep being tormented eternally. And he is mentioning hadith that the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Imam Ahmad recorded, the Messenger of Allah said, أَمَّا أَهْلُ النَّارِ الَّذِينَ هُمْ أَهْلُهَا لَا يَمُوتُونَ وَلَا يَحْيُونَ. He said the people who are destined for hell eternally, khulud, yani, they don't die nor live. Yani they're in a state where they're always dying, but they're not dying. وَأَمَّا أُنَاسٌ يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِهِمُ الرَّحْمَةِ فَيُمِيتُهُمْ فِي النَّارِ. As for people who, there are some that will fire, but temporarily, not eternally. And those ones, once they are punished, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cause them to die in the fire. And then Allah will allow intercessors to intercede for them, so they take them out of the hellfire, whatever is left of them. And Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. And they will plant them by the river of life in heaven. And that river is in heaven, and they will grow as plants grow back, and they will be in heaven. So two types of people. And Prophet ﷺ, he says, don't you see that the trees some are green, then they turn yellow, then they turn green again? So this is what will happen to these people. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ تَزَكَّى. The one who makes tazkiyah and purifies himself. And this is today people, they say, they reject tazkiyah. They say Islam is the five pillars. You don't need. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا. And here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He wins, He succeeds those who make tazkiyah to nafs, purify themselves. Purify themselves from bad manners, purify themselves from bad ideas, purify themselves from sins. وَذَكَرَ اسْمَ رَبِّهِ فَصَلَّى. And again, how you purify yourself, the ones who purify themselves and make dhikr. Dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ذكر اسم ربه فصلى. You find our Wahhabi brothers say, oh, you cannot say make dhikr with Allah. If you go to a masjid, you sit with a few people and say Allah, 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 you'll find somebody in a Wahhabi masjid or a Salafi masjid come and say, haram brother, you can't make dhikr with al-ism al-mufrad. It is bid'ah, it is this, it is that. You can't say make dhikr of Allah. You can say only Subhanallah. You can say Alhamdulillah, but you can't say Allah. And here, this verse says, وَذَكَرَ اسْمَ رَبِّهِ, and he mentions the name. He wins the ones who purify himself, and he mentions the name of his Lord by Allah. What is the name of our Lord? What is ism al-jami'? It's Allah. So how are you going to mention the name of your Lord if you can't mention the name of your Lord in dhikr? وَذَكَرَ اسْمَ رَبِّهِ فَصَلَّى, and he prayed. بَلْ تُؤْثِرُونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا. Verily, you lean towards, you prefer this low life. This life is called dunya, means it is low. It is the lowest in terms of the scale or status, the lowest kind of life is the life, hayat al-dunya, the ones we are living here. That's why it's called dunya, lowly. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you prefer this low life on eternal life, on illiyin, on jinan, on heavens. وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى. And the afterlife is better and it is everlasting. This has been recorded in الصحف الأولى. This has been recorded in former scriptures. The scripture of Ibrahim, Sayyidina Ibrahim and Sayyidina Musa. أم لم ينبأ بما في صحف موسى وإبراهيم الذي وفى ألا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى وأن ليس للإنسان إلا ما سعى وأن سعيه سوف يرى ثم يجزاه الجزاء الأوفى وأن إلى ربك المنتهى. He is reinforcing the meaning of the verses we just mentioned by using other verses from the Quran, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, has he not been informed with that which is in the scripture of Sayyidina Musa and Sayyidina Ibrahim, who alladhi wafa, who fulfilled his duty. Alla taziru waziratun wizra ukhra, that no one is going to carry the sin of another and the burden of another. Wa an laysa lil insani illa ma sa'a, and a person has nothing to show except these of that he's performed. وَأَنَّ سَعْيَهُ سَوْفَ يُرَى, and that he is, everything he does is observed and recorded, and that he will be given full payment either way, in goodness or punishment on Judgment Day. وَأَنَّ إِلَى رَبِّكَ الْمُنْتَهَى, and verily to your Lord everything ends, everything. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد. I think we will end to, with this, although we still have 10 minutes, but I am, as you can see, I'm not in my home, invited to iftar somewhere. So we'll end it here, inshallah. And tomorrow night is اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. Tonight, tonight, if you started Monday, if you started Ramadan on Monday, tonight is the night of the 17th. Tonight is the night of Badr. Yawm al-Furqan, the day of distinguishing between falsehood and truth, when Prophet ﷺ took his companions, 313 companions, and the Battle of Badr took place. It will take place on tomorrow, يعني, during the day. But Prophet spent this night, it was the first Ramadan, second day a year of Hijri, and the companions were fasting on the 17th of Ramadan. And Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ said that he spent the whole night in Munajat, and the entire night praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Ahl al-Turuq, they take this night to be a special night in Ramadan, and they make tawassul and intercession with the companions of Badr. They are the most honored amongst all the companions, are the companions of Badr. So they seek Allah's intercession through their names. But since we, right now it's not the 17th, tomorrow, inshallah's program, we will recite Jaliyatul Qadr, we recite a poem that has the names of the companions of Badr, and we will ask their intercession, inshallah. Wa min Allahi tawfiq, bi hurmatil habib, bi hurmatil fatiha, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Thank you for watching. Jazakumullah khairan. Ramadan is going quickly. Please make dua. Use your dua, especially at the time of iftar. And we'll see you tomorrow, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.